docking stations are not cheap. They come at a higher price than the affordable price category rate. But fortunately, I have found the one and only Drive docking station which is available on Amazon for just ₹1299. Other docking stations are priced at ₹3000 minimum, and this docking station is just lesser than half of the ₹3000. So let's see what this docking station looks like and how does it work. In this video, you will see unboxing, installation, setup and quick speed test also of the docking station. This is the box of the PiBox docking station HDD dock. As you can see, it supports both the size of drives, 2.5 inch SATA drives and 3.5 inch big SATA drives. 5 Gbps max speed it can go up to with the USB 3.0. you can also visit their website and order from them, or you can directly order from Amazon using the link given in the description box. Here are some specifications, which are basic specifications, so no need to go deeper into this. Installation is also pretty simple, like a normal hard disk or SSD enclosures, just connecting the hard disk, which I will show you. So let's unbox to see what do we get inside. This is just an installation instruction. You can read this if you want, if you order this. And here are the adapters. This is the USB 3.0 cable. USB 3.0. This is a power adapter for big 3.5 inch hard disk drives, because they need more power to run than 2.5 inch hard disk drives or normal 2.5 inch SSDs. Now this is the docking station. So let's open this. This is the docking station, nice, small and looking good. Here are vents for ventilation. This is the docking area. Here you can see the SATA ports, the SATA and the power port here. This is the rear side of the docking station. This is the on off switch. This is the data switch. Here the other end of the USB cable will go. This plug will get inserted here and this end will insert into your PC. On this side also, the back side of the box, we have vents, which is good. So these are the things which we got in the box. Now let me show you the installation. The USB cable is also thick and durable. So let's insert this and just set up. So let's do a basic setup here only. The wire is long enough for desktops and laptops both. For laptops, it's a little longer, but it's good anyways that you can keep the docking station anywhere because of this long cable. Next is the 12 volt adapter. Here is my 3.5 inch hard disk drive. So we are done with the basic setup of the station. Now let's move on to the PC and start this up. Now this docking station is completely ready for startup. I just have to insert this plug into the power outlet so that this device can start spinning up. So the plug has been inserted and turned on. So let's turn this on first. As you can see, we have the light here and the light near the vents also. The drive is spinning. I can hear the sound. So let's connect this docking station through USB with my desktop to see if this drive gets detected or not, or it's even working or not. Here is the USB 3.0 port, and now I am connecting it with my USB port of this PC. I have connected. The lights was blinking but did not got a notification on my PC here. So let's check. So let's check if it's visible in the desktop or not. Okay, yes, it's visible. As you can see, the drive is visible here. Let's check in the task manager. The drive is visible. And let's also do a small speed test. I'm using Crystal Disk Mark 8.0.4x64. Let's start the test. the lights are blinking during the test. I think these lights blink when there's a read or write activity from the drive. As you can see, I'm keeping the task manager window also open so that you can see the speeds. The speeds is going 204. So the speeds are great with this adapter. The docking station, it's really giving close to the actual speeds that I was getting when it was connected directly with the SATA port of my PC's motherboard. So that's great. The speeds are also very constant. It's not dropping. So that's also very great. Did not expect it this, that it will give this high speed, which is almost same as the SATA port speeds of the motherboard. But this is really giving it. And it's more than that. When this drive was connected with the SATA port of my PC, I used to get speed somewhere around 180 Mbps, megabytes per second. But with this docking station, I'm really getting the full speed of the drive, which is 204 megabytes per second. So this is really a good improvement. And also the reason for buying this adapter or docking station was that because of lack of space in the cabinet, the cable, the SATA cables and the power cables used to get bent, and this drive was getting disconnected in between. I used to get the disk errors in the event viewer, so I will show you that also. So because of lack of space and the cables getting bent, I bought this adapter to solve the problem, and I think this is really helping me now. In case you also have a similar problem like me, that you do not have a space inside your cabinet and the drive is getting disconnected because of cables getting bent over more than 90 degrees, or there's a hard bend in the cables and the drive keeps getting disconnected, or your games and apps keeps getting closed, so you can open the event viewer by right clicking the Windows icon and check for warnings, disk warnings. If you are getting that, you can also buy this docking station and run your hard disk via USB. The write speed is also good, means this is really a good docking station with USB 3.0 and the power adapter giving correct or enough power to this drive, and it's working perfectly fine. So the drive test has been completed and the results are actually really good. Now let me show you the event viewers error that I was getting. So let's see if there's any error during this time. If there is, that means that we'll see with the results, but warning is 8. I don't think, okay, so there, luckily there is no error with disk or event 51. As you can see, there are only these are normal warnings. We do not have to worry about these. So as you can see, there is no disk error. So I was getting these disk errors. So because of bending cables, my hard disk used to get disconnected, and hence I bought this docking station because I was fed up with these errors and my drive getting disconnected whenever I'm working or playing games. But now, around a minute or two ago, the test was completed and there is no disk warnings. So great. The dock is really doing what I thought it would do and it would help me. So for me, the docking station is really good. One more thing which I would like to recommend you is to not bend this docking station forwards or backwards while you are moving it. So don't move this drive more frequently or keep changing its position, because the SATA ports or the ports of this docking station may get bent because these hard drives are really heavy. The build quality is also really good, and the plastic and the material is also very durable. It does not look cheap, looks very premium. The ports and the cables are also thick and made up of good quality, which is durable and will definitely last long. The great part is that it does not look messy. All the cables are running from the rear side of the docking station, so mostly they cannot be even seen. And regarding turning off or a proper closure of this, just after shutting down the PC, turn this off from the rear and turn the on off switch. The lights will go off and then it will be a proper shutdown. So this was all about the PieBox India 2.5 inch or 3.5 inch docking station. If you want to buy this, I have given the link of the product page in the description box below. Also, let me know your thoughts regarding this PieBox India docking station that costs just ₹1299. But what about the hard disk? If you also want to see the review of the Seagate Barracuda 1TB 7200 RPM hard disk review, then this video is for you. Thanks for watching this video. Like, share and subscribe, and I will see you in the next one.